Hello everyone, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to talk about the lytic cycle of the or the multiplication of the viruses, which is by the lytic cycle. So, we will be discussing about the lytic cycle of the virus particles. So, the multiplication process in case of lytic cycle, this is mostly by the virulent phages, which means the phage which can create the lysis of the cell wall and it does not integrate into the host genome. And these are called the lytic cycle. Why they are called the lytic cycle? Because it causes the host bacterium is lysed at the end of this cycle. So, the host bacterium cell wall is ruptured and the new virus particles are released. So, it is a lysis of the host cell. Hence, it is known as the lytic cycle of the virus particle. Now, let us talk about the process or the steps which is followed or which happens during the lytic cycle. So, the first step which happens during a lytic cycle is known as the adsorption. What happens here? Here, take a look on the picture. Here, the virus particle first attaches itself to the surface of the host. So, this is the host bacterium and this is the virus particle. So, here the viral particle attaches itself on the host organism. How this attachment takes place? This as attachment can take place by the help of some specific receptors. And these specific receptors are present on the surface of the host organism. As you can see over here, these dotted structures, these are the specific receptors which can be recognized by the tail fibers of the virus particle. So, because of these receptors, the virus can attach itself to the surface of the host. Now, the attachment helps is happening with the help of the tail fibers. Now, after the first step of adsorption, the second step which happens is the penetration. So, the virus has firmly attached itself to the surface of the host organism. Now, what happens? The penetration or the penetration of the tail fiber into the host organism. Here, the injection of the nucleic acid happens. The nucleic acid, which is the genome of the virus particle, that is injected inside the host organism. How this happens? Here, the tail sheath, which we know, it is made up of proteins, about 200 capsomers. So, these proteins, this protein sheath, they can contract, they can reduce its size and it can act like an injection. So, it can contract and the central tube is now pushed inside the host organism. As you can see over here, this yellow part, this central tube has been pushed inside the host organism because the tail fibers have contracted. Now, this is a very active process. It uses the ATP energy molecule, which is known as ATP. So, it is an active process. It uses energy in order to perform these activities. Now, the host is the part of the virus, which is basically the proteins devoid of the genetic material. This host, this remains attached to the cell wall. So, it cannot enter. Only the genetic material or the nucleic acids can enter through the tail fiber inside the host organism. Now, we have discussed that the tail fibers, they have got certain lysozymes or hydrolytic enzymes. Now, these tail fibers here on the surface of the host organism where it has attached itself, it creates hole. And through this hole, this type of central tube is pushed inside and hence the nucleic acid passes into the host organism. So, after the step of penetration, the third step which happens, this is known as eclipse phase. So, here what happens, the further infection by the same type of phage is prevented. So, this is a very interesting phenomena. If a certain type of phage has infected a bacterium, what happens? It does not allow the similar type of phages to infect that bacterium. It will cause unnecessary competition for the resources. So, hence it does not allow further infection. And this has been given a term which is known as super infection immunity. So, it does not allow the infection of further same type of virus particle onto the same host organism. This happens because of the production of certain enzymes which are known as the repressor enzymes. So, these enzymes are capable of preventing these type of super infection immunity by certain type of virus particles. Now, these causes the suppression of the host cellular activities. The host basic cellular activities are now suppressed because the virus is now wanting to multiply itself. So, host cellular activities, those are suppressed. This causes the synthesis of some types of proteins. First of all, the early proteins and then the late proteins. Early proteins are the new enzymes which are made because of which the hole inside of the host cell organism that is sealed. Those are the early proteins, and the late proteins are those proteins which actually help in the formation of the capsomeres and the assembling of the virus particles. So early and hence followed by the late proteins are formed in this type of eclipse phase. So after this phase, the fourth phase comes, which is known as the maturation phase. Here what happens, the assembly of various components occurs. Now the head and the tail and the various components of the tail, those are made separately and not as a whole. So first they are made separately and then those are assembled. So here you can see properly assembled virus particles, but these all particles, head, the tail and the tail fibers, those all are made separately. Now there are two periods or there are two phases. The time period between the injection and the appearance of a first new phage, this time period is known as the eclipse period, whereas the time period between the injection and the rupture of the cell wall of the host organism is ruptured. Now this rupturing of the cell wall, this phase is known as the latent period. So there are two important periods, that is the eclipse period and the latent period. And now the last step of this lytic cycle is known as the lysis and the release of the virus particles. So what happens here? Now the cells or the virus particles are increasing in number. After it reaches a threshold value till which it can hold inside the host organism, what happens? The cell wall bursts at the end of the latent period. Once the latent period is over, then the cell wall bursts open and the virus particles which are present inside the host organism, those are all released. Now the number of virions or virus particles that are produced per host cell is given a term which is known as the burst size. So the number of virus particle which can be produced inside a particular host organism is known as the burst size. So now let us take a quick look on the all the steps that are followed in the lytic cycle. So what are those? First, we have seen the attachment of the virus particle onto the surface of the host organism by the help of tail fibers. After that, what happens? The tail fibers, it contracts because of contracting protein sheath. What happens? The virus genome is released inside the host organism. Now, the host organism, the virus particles, now it tries to synthesize its own proteins, its head proteins and tail fibers. And then what happens? The synthesis of viral genomes and proteins happens over here. After that, it helps, it actually, the assembly of the virus particles happens. That is the head and the tails, which were made separately. Now they assemble together to give the proper structure of a lytic virus particle. Now you can see over here, the head, tails and the tail fibers, they are formed separately. Now after that, it has formed a full-fledged virus particle. And at the last, it is followed by the release of the virus particle once it reaches a threshold value. So in this video, we have talked about the lytic phase of the virus particle and we have talked about the various phases or stages of the lytic cycle. I hope you have understood and liked this video. Thank you.